Hey guys, welcome back to part four. In this one, we're going to set up our website ready for a Dreamweaver. Now, before I start any of this, you're gonna laugh at me, but I am using the old Dreamweaver version 8. I'm doing this for a class that these tutorials, and this is what we have. Feel free to use a newer version of Dreamweaver if you have it. I also actually own Dreamweaver 6, CS6, and it's gonna be Creative Cloud soon. I also use Adobe Muse. Muse isn't too bad. It's pretty cool. But yeah, Macromedia Dreamweaver 8. Now I did check it out. I think the first Dreamweaver I used was maybe CS2, or maybe it was this one. I can't remember, but I am. The one that I've used the most is probably CS3, CS3 or CS4. I haven't tried CS6 yet, but they're all, they're quite, similar, It's all about templates, and this comes with not much. The newest version comes with like HTML5 templates and stuff, but we could just download the templates if we wanted. We will be using the, there's a template that comes with this anyway that we need to use, if you are still following my technique, okay? I'm just going to minimize this for the time being. In the previous video, we created a folder called website. Okay, this is going to be where our website's hosted. In the root, we're going to have all of our web pages. So you have what's called your index page, which is your home page, and then any other pages for your website. We will have a folder called CSS, which all your CSS rules go into, and there'll also be places for if you wanted to go ahead and do JavaScript after, which we might look at. I think I will be looking at it at the very end, okay, to do some maybe galleries or something. So everything goes in here, okay? And the idea is that you don't want this to be too big a file size, okay? Images, of course, is the big killer. You'll never put videos or audio onto this, For video, you want to go for YouTube embedding, Vimeo embedding. If you want to embed audio, you probably want to use Bandcamp or SoundCloud, okay? But we're going to create an index page, and we're not actually going to create it if you're using this method. We're going to be using the code that comes with this setup, okay? So we can actually drag in this demo, this HTML file here called demo, okay? Just going to bring that in. I'm going to rename that to index. I don't think I need that folder, but I'm going to bring it in anyway. And we definitely need this CSS folder, okay? This is all your, it's called cascading style sheets. And it's just your formatting and all that, okay? It works independently from the HTML itself. Just going to copy those two in, plonk them in there. And that should be us, okay? So let me see, just come out of that. And in Dreamweaver, I'm going to, I think I'm going to set up a Dreamweaver site. Let me click Dreamweaver site. I'm going to call it, I don't normally do it through this. Just going to call this website. Okay, so this is going to be like a setup through this, okay? Not going to have a HTTP just yet. Under advanced, going to change this root folder to website, okay? I'm going to select this folder. So it's gonna be able to refresh the files and stuff for us. Makes it a bit easier. Click OK, and we should. Damn it! It's actually used my desktop folder instead of my website folder. I am just gonna change that. Don't know why it done that. What's the name of that folder? Website, I think. Please use that folder. Hit OK. Okay. Thank you. There we go. So there we go. We now have our folder actually, synchronized in here, okay? So we can refresh this, and it refreshes files for you. If you drag stuff in here, it just works nicer, okay? And what we can then do is double-click our index folder, and you get something a bit crazy like this, okay? Depending on what version of, Dreamweaver you're using, it might look different or it might not, okay? Here we have our grid system, okay? We are going to get rid of all this, okay? This is just templates. We have our design view, we have split view, okay, so we can actually look at the code at the same time. I hate this version of Dreamweaver because in newer versions this is actually, you know, vertical, which makes a lot more sense than this. No, don't think we can change it, which is a pain. We can see the code only, okay, so we'll be doing a lot of this code on its own. And we will be doing some stuff in design. So maybe like the likes of typing is quite easy to do in design mode. Placing images and stuff, okay. You do have the, you know, your formatting down here, you have your tags and your CSS over here. You have insert image, image objects, so you have your rollover images and stuff. So a lot of it is actually, you know, relatively similar to newer versions of Dreamweaver by Adobe. I'm just going to change the title of our web page, which is in here, or we can do it in code view. It's at the very top under title. Okay, I'm going to call this home page. Enter, and it does change over here. Let me just see what else we need to do. Just need to make sure that this is all set up. Okay, so this is referencing the CSS folder. Just need to make sure it is the same. It is the same. Okay, so these are at the very top, just above your header, or sorry, in the header even. We need to have, you know, you have the title of the website, you have them linking to other aspects or other assets. So this is linking to CSS rules, okay, and our CSS rules are in there. It's using these 960 grid system CSS rules. In time we will probably make new ones, okay, and when it comes to formatting backgrounds and things like that. Okay, so well done if you've got this far. What I might do now is save everything. I think where it says body, okay, so everything in this body section is what's actually going to be visible in the web page, okay. So I'm going to get rid of all this crap, select it all, okay, and I'm going to delete it like so. And if I go back to my design view, I should now have a pure empty web page, okay, and this is now where we're going to do the meaty stuff in the next video, okay. So we have you know, empty template, our CSS rules plugged in. Let's expand that. So everything we're going to do is inside this body section, okay, in code. And we can look at this split, we can look at this in design mode or whatever, okay. So now you have this all set up. In the next video we're actually going to get cracking on bringing our content in, okay. So thanks for watching.